Hey everybody, it's Carly the Pink Scrapper, and I have a cool project that I have been thinking about for a long time, and I finally decided to sit down and get it done. And anyways, I really should just write things down so I don't forget them, but this is a fun way to repurpose something. And when I started doing my YouTube videos, I had kind of found that I was recycling a lot, and there wasn't a lot of people recycling things. Now I've come to find out there's actually a term for it called repurposing, which is awesome. I love to see that people are doing it, and especially scrapbookers, because we use a lot of paper. So I don't mind making a sacrifice to use cardboard or chipboard from your cereal boxes or wherever you can find it, because it's free. It doesn't cost a thing. Just time, and it's not easy, but it is free. So here's my project, and I don't think anybody's done this before, so I hope I'm the first one, because I like to be different. Okay, so here's my problem, and I find that I'm really a big problem solver. So I have this mini that I made, and you know, you make minis of all different sizes, and you know, I put them around my house and then switch them out. And so what I found was that I wanted to make a case for it. Okay, so here's my idea. I found a way to repurpose something and then solve my problem of making a case. So this album is a 6x6. I need to make a case for it, and I don't know what the term would be for it. Maybe a mini box. Anyway, so this is what's gonna happen. It's gonna go right in there, and I can put it on my shelf, and I can pull my minis out. Now, if I wanted to turn this around so it's all uniform, and don't mind the name, I'm just recycling and repurposing. If I want to turn it around and have this on my bookcase, then it's all uniform. That's the word, uniform. So, and then you turn it around and you can check out the mini that you made. And you can even write on this inside, you know, the name of your mini, when you made it, or whatever. So I'm going to get started, and you'll see I'm going to skip some steps because I know that you can use a scissors and a X-Acto knife pretty well, because that's what I use. So this album's a 6x6, and so I had cut my album in half, or excuse me, the box in half that I'm repurposing. And so it was kind of, it was probably bigger than that. And so I cut it down, and my goal was to get a 7-inch box. Okay, so I cut all the way around, and inside are these flaps, and you can move them wherever you need them to be to kind of get them out of the way. So this is what I thought I'd do. I thought that I would just glue them together. And how am I going to do that? Well, I'm going to use my extra paper, or my my scrap paper, of course, because you know I'm going to cover that up. And I put my box pieces together, and let's see, it does measure about 7 inches. And so at first I was going to put them into each other, but that kind of just didn't work. You know, they got lumpy. And then I decided, well, I'm just going to put them together like this, and then I'm going to connect them with a piece of scrap paper. So this is in my scrap bin. I ran it through my Xyron machine. And you can just use packing tape, but I couldn't find mine. I was shipping something off, and so I lost it. So anyway, so here is what I'm doing. Just gonna kind of center it and push it together. and then it's going to pretty much stick. And I can cut this little piece off here as well. So, it's got the other side. And it doesn't matter that they don't match because I'm going to cover this with paper. And actually, I'm going to cover this with coordinating paper from my mini. So, let's see if I can... I think I'm just going to cut that little piece off. Okay, there we go. So it gives a nice smooth edge to cover. And your mini will fit in there. So these are the coordinating pieces I've chosen. It's actually the Old World paper pack from Die Cuts With a View. And I like these purple colors. I like this purple color. So I decided that that was going to go probably on the front, and I was going to fold this into it like that. So you can see it's all the way butt up against the side there. And I'm just going to use Mod Podge. So anyways, you can see how it fits. And I just wanted to cover a little bit that goes into here. You could probably cover even more, but it's not necessary. So you need to save some paper. Okay, so let me get my supplies and I'll be right back. Okay, so I've got my Mod Podge ready and my box is ready, looking pretty cool here. And so I'm gonna put a layer of Mod Podge down and then grab my purple paper, and I actually cut it down to 6.5 inches because when I measured it, it was about 6.5 inches. And let's Mod Podge the bottom now since I cut it too small, but I'm not really worried about it. In the end, it'll all work out, right? Okay, the scrapping shouldn't be too hard for, shouldn't be too stressful. Okay, so here's my piece. Just gonna fold it down. And you can put your hand inside to apply pressure. Okay, I need a little bit more glue here. Okay, now let's see if my piece of paper fits. There we go. And it's getting dry, so I'm going to put more on there. A lot of people use gesso, but I can't find a white or a clear gesso. So, I don't know. I'll just keep looking. I know my stores here don't have it. Okay, now I'm going to paint this with Mod Podge and then tuck it in. Okay, so far so good.